Good morning, everyone. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary and her Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that we may glory in the feast of the Blessed Apostle Thomas, so that we may always be sustained by his intercession, and believing may have life, in the name of Christ your Son, whom Thomas acknowledged as the Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you are no longer strangers and sojourners, but you are fellow citizens with the holy ones and members of the household of God, built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the capstone. Through him, the whole structure is held together and grows into a temple sacred in the Lord. In him, you are also being built together into a dwelling place of God in the Spirit, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
Praise the Lord, all you nations. Glorify him, all you peoples.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news.
For steadfast is his kindness for us, and the fidelity of the Lord endures forever.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Alleluia!
Put your finger here and see my hands.
and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe. Thomas answered and said to him, My Lord and my God. Jesus said to him, You have come to believe because you have seen me. Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, the Lord Jesus Christ. By our very nature, we like to see evidence of things. We like to see things for their really substantial worth. And we want to know the answers why this happened or why that happened. And sometimes we wrestle with these things in life in general. You know, even the mystery of science and medicine. We all want to know the answer. Everybody wants immediately the answer to the coronavirus. We need to get this under control. And all the things of this world and this earth, I think you and I understand how precious it is and how delicate it is. And it happens to us over a period of time, even during this period. You and I like things done immediately. That's just how our nature works. We like to get things accomplished, check it off our list. Let's go to the next thing. When it comes to our faith, you and I have to really be patient as well. So the physical world and the spiritual world, allowing time to take its course in us and to be patient with God. There's always a teachable moment in every circumstance. Even the things that are most difficult and cross-bearing. There's always a lesson for us to learn. But if we're always running and rushing and wanting this check and that check, we don't always get it. We don't always understand, and we don't always allow the whole meaning to take root in our life. This was an important occurrence in the life of the church, you know? Here they were all gathered without Thomas, and the Lord appeared to them. And then they said to Thomas, Oh, the Lord appeared. And Thomas said, I won't believe that until I actually see it and I actually put my hand to his side. I think sometimes you and I give Thomas a bad rap. All of us take time in allowing all of the mysteries of life to settle into our very being. There are mysteries of faith, absolutely. And it needs time for us to digest them. One of the things we have to understand is that God gives us the grace to believe. We just have to be open to that. And that all things are possible with God's grace. I know you believe that, and I do too. But our faith is tested when we go under trial and when things become difficult for us. And sometimes our faith is shaken. And then we question and we doubt. It's easy to believe when everything's going fine. But when things are not going fine, it's when faith is tested. Jesus appears again to them.
and he walks through the door. The doors were locked. They were in fear. And Jesus gives them the Easter greeting. Peace be with you. And then he says to Thomas, take your finger and place them into my hands. Place your hand and put it into my side. And do not persist in your unbelief, but believe. Do you ever think about the glorified body of Jesus? What did Jesus look like after the resurrection? And then, what's very interesting is, he allowed the marks of the crucifixion to remain on the glorified body. Now, you and I would probably think, oh, they would be all like healed up. Why would our Lord ever want to show us the nail marks of the crucifixion? How horrible that would be. And even where the spear went right into his side. Close that up, Jesus. Don't let people see that. It's the resurrection now. And yet Jesus allows that to remain, because that was the means by which life was attained. It was through those nail marks that you and I received salvation. It was by his very body on the cross. And it goes to show them and helps them understand as well as us that despite all the difficulties and trials of life and its pain and its agony that afflicts the physical body, it will receive new life. It will be glorified. And it's the flesh that gives hinge to salvation. We say that, and the church believes it. Without the flesh of Jesus on the cross, there would be no salvation. That's why as Catholics, the body is on the cross. Our Protestant brothers and sisters, the body's off the cross. For Catholics, the body's on the cross. And that's because of what we believe. There's where we differ. Yes, Jesus is risen from the dead, but it was through the body that he saved us. It wasn't through wood. It wasn't through the wood of the cross. The wood didn't save you. The body saved you and saved me. It was an instrument that was used for the crucifixion, and the body was placed on it. So that's why it's always both end, the wood and the body. And then Thomas made a very fundamental, powerful statement. He said, my Lord. And then he said that other statement, my God. Now, just take for a moment that statement. My Lord. Okay, absolutely. Because these apostles were with him for how many years? 3 years, right? So they listened to everything, they watched everything, they were the eyewitnesses to all the accounts. Then he's crucified and placed in the tomb. And now he appears in his glorified body. And Thomas, without any question of a doubt, understands that Jesus is God. That Jesus is God. You and I reflect upon this many times as we understand the Trinity, because that's even a mystery, isn't it? Three divine persons, one God. How did that all happen? What does that mean? How do I understand it? And that statement for Thomas to say that was an acknowledgement that Jesus was just not a prophet or some nice guy or some holy man, that Jesus was God in the flesh. And how Thomas touched the flesh of God and made that statement. When you and I receive Holy Communion, we touch the flesh of God. Either the flesh of our tongue or the flesh of our hand. That's why Holy Communion must always be flesh on flesh. You can't wear gloves. It always has to be flesh on flesh. Whether the tongue of the flesh of the tongue or the flesh of the hand. And when we go to communion, we say, my Lord and my God. We receive in the upper room, the place where this happened. We receive at the altar of the cross, the sacrifice. And then we go to announce this to all we meet by our daily lives. Jesus said to him, have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen me and believe. May God help our unbelief at times. May God help us when we need everything tested. May God truly help us to believe in the Eucharist, in the Incarnation, in the Virgin Birth. May He help us to understand and believe about the kingdom and about His presence. Because we did see, we have come, and we have touched the very flesh of God.
Reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For Pope Francis, successor to the apostles, may he be filled with spiritual gifts and graces as he continues to preach the gospel to all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our elected officials and all who serve with them, may God protect them from all evil in the exercise of their duties. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
So that all of us may further the mission of Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you, if they are in accord with your holy will. We ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God of heaven.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God of heaven.
The blood of the new and eternal covenant,
which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us all move. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Bring your hand and feel the place of the nails, and do not be unbelieving, but believing. For those of you watching virtually, now is the time for you to make a spiritual communion. My
Let us pray. O God, as we truly receive in this sacrament the body of your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that we may recognize him with the Apostle Thomas by faith as our Lord and our God, and proclaim him by our deeds and by our life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Tomorrow is the 4th of July, everybody, Independence Day, and as we mentioned, as we have been doing for the last several years, is that 8:15 in the morning we'll begin with what is called a patriotic rosary. That's very nice. And we'll take the time to pray that rosary, and then after that, at 9 o'clock, we'll have our usual morning mass, followed by a period of adoration